Hello and welcome to WordPress Tutorials. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to add custom post type, for example, portfolio to your WordPress website. And I needed this thing because it was one of my client's requirement, and the theme does not have any portfolio option. So I decided to add it and also make a video for you to understand how you can make a custom post type, as well as you can add custom fields, for example, image, business name, business address, or something, some details about the projects. Different projects needs different custom custom fields. So I'll show you some basic custom fields to be added to the portfolio custom post type. So for registering the custom post type, we will need a plugin. So come to your plugins, add new, search for custom post type and press enter. Okay, this is the plugin, custom post UI. And this plugin doesn't work with your version of WordPress, so you will have to update the WordPress if you have older version. I already have a newer version on another site, so I'll use this. I already started update. Okay, I already updated my WordPress to the latest version. So for custom post type UI, click on install now. Activate the plugin. And now we will need another plugin called ACF, which is advanced custom fields. We will need custom fields for our portfolio custom post type. So after activating this plugin, we will install that one. Open plugins, add new. Now type advanced custom fields and press enter. Now install advanced custom fields. Click on install now. Now click on activate. After activating both advanced custom fields and custom post type UI, come to CPT UI and click on add or edit post types. We do not have any post type yet, so we will add a new post type by the name of portfolio. Type the slug of this post type. In my case, a slug will be portfolio, but if it's without spaces, if it have any space, then you can use the hyphenation portfolio slug or something like this. But in this case, it's only one word, so it will be in small letters, and plural label will be portfolio. Single legal also portfolio. Auto populate labels. Okay, add post type. Now you can see that there is a portfolio item in our menu, right sidebar menu, left sidebar menu. Okay, here if you come to the portfolio, then you can see that the portfolio post type is done. Now we will do some changes. Click on edit post types. Select the post type you want to edit. We only have one post type. You can change the slug or any of these three things. Now here we will add some additional labels. For example, menu name is already portfolio, so we will not change it. All items will be portfolio items. Add new portfolio. Add portfolio. And similarly, you can add all these labels. I'll leave all of them for now, and click on save post type. Now if you open the portfolio items and see, then you can add a new portfolio, and then we will add some custom fields to the portfolio and after that I'll show you how to populate all these things in the single portfolio page using Elementor plugin. Click on add portfolio. Okay, on add new page you can see that there is no category. For adding category option, you will have to open the CPT UI again, and here you can see add or edit taxonomies. Open this link. Here you can give the portfolio taxonomy slug. So we will use portfolio dash or underscore cat. So plural label will be portfolio category. Use the title case, and singular label will be portfolio category. Okay, multiple will be categories, and attach to portfolio. Click on add taxonomy. Now open the add new page again and refresh it. Now you can see there is a field for portfolio categories, and there is also a section for portfolio taxonomy. You can also add featured image, title, description, and this is the extra settings because I'm using extra theme, and this is the extra layout settings for that theme. Okay, now if we add a portfolio, but first let's add some categories. I'll add construction and next one will be mapping, next one survey. Now we have three categories added. Come to the add new page again and refresh it. Type in the first project name, house build, and choose the category construction. Select it, give it some description. This is a sample description for this portfolio, and choose the image, set featured image. I'll add a dummy image for now. Click on set featured image. Now all these things are ready, but now we will add some extra fields. For example, for this type of projects we will need a construction date, completion date, and location. So we will add these three fields using custom fields, advanced custom fields. Click on field groups, click on add new in the field groups. Now name it, my field group will be portfolio fields, and rules will be post type is equal to portfolio, active yes, standard meta box, position normal after contents. Okay, publish. After setting up the field group, you can now add custom fields. Click on this add field button, and our first field will be project start date. Field type text, or you can choose date from the drop down. Required yes. Okay, add another field which will be project completion date. Field name will be this, and this is also a date picker. Required yes. And now add location or address, project address, field name text, and required yes. Now click on publish, update. Now there are three fields in this field group. Come to your add new portfolio again and refresh the page. Okay, it's not saved yet. First publish this portfolio. After publishing the portfolio, you can see that there are now three extra fields. If you click in the date field, you will be able to choose the date from the calendar. So I'll choose 1/1/2020, and the completion will be June 4, 2020. Project address will be Islamabad. You can give it a complete address, but I'm just showing you how to show these on the front end. Click on update and let's see how this portfolio will look like on the front end. Okay, as we do not have any single page for this portfolio, then it's very simple and nothing fancy. Just the title, description and image are showing, and no custom fields are mentioned here. So now we will design a beautiful template for our portfolio custom post type. I already have Elementor installed. Now click on Elementor and click on Templates Theme Builder. On the Theme Builder page, click on Add New and select Single and select post type, which is portfolio, and our template name will be portfolio template. Create template. Okay, now it's editable in the templates Elementor page builder. So we have a full width template which have menu, footer and contents in the middle. First we will add a full column or two column layout, and in the left we will add an image which is the featured image of the portfolio, and in the right column we will add title, post excerpt, contents, post title. And the next will be project start date and project end date and address. So click here, post title, paste link. It's a heading, but we will customize it for getting the custom fields from address, post date, project starting date and end date. Now we will add heading here and customize it to what element you want to show here, and choose the dynamic tags, and there are some fields from ACF fields, which is project start date for the first one and next one will be, just copy this, duplicate, and next one will be project completion date. And the third one will be address. Now add post contents. Below these fields, or you can add them in the full width row. Now centralize these three columns, these three rows. You can add headings to them so you know what are these for, and finally the contents, the post contents. Now all these things are dynamic and it will vary from portfolio to portfolio. Click on save. It will be applied on all portfolio section because featured image is automatically grabbed from a particular portfolio item. The title, these custom fields and the post contents are also got from each portfolio individually. So if we open this portfolio now, then you will be able to see this in the new template which we just created in the Elementor page builder. This is a very basic template and you can design anything you want to place it. So this was all for today's video. Please give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe to our channel so you won't miss our future updates. Thank you.